Hello, I'm Beto Arcos. I'm a music journalist, and I'm a regular contributor to NPR, the BBC, and KPCC. I recently interviewed three artists that have performed at the Soraya, and I asked them to tell me about their experience performing at the Soraya, the power of music, and also to talk about the times we're living today. First, we'll hear from singer Lila Downs, then from pianist Arturo O'Farrell, and we'll close with singer Eugenia León from Mexico City.
When we came to perform at the Soraya Center, people were very gracious with us and made us feel at home. I really enjoyed performing there because I felt like there was a strong Latino community and, of course, a Mexican-American community and a sense of empowerment in the community. I remember Monsieur Periné and performing with them, and it was a really fun night. And I say hello. I think as an artist, to feel the sense that we have lost our freedom in a way is very important, to come to terms with that in all respects. What does it mean for the future of humanity? What does it mean to stay enclosed and look within yourself? And also, how will the next steps that I take make a difference? And I think we all ask ourselves at one point these questions, and through music and through art we are able to express in a poetic way these realities. And so it's about expressing the emotion and the sensations that we are having right now. So I think it's a challenging time, but it's also very, very good for creation. And for all of us who are writing songs, it's a time to reflect on the bigger issues, I think.
The Afro-Latin Jazz Orchestra was created to answer the proposition, what would happen if there was a much larger view of Latin music than just Cuba and Puerto Rico? And so we created the orchestra 12 years ago. Our birthplace was jazz at Lincoln Center. And then 5 years after that, we became our own entity. We have our own nonprofit, the Afro-Latin Jazz Line. Since then, we've done work with music from all over Latin America with all kinds of genres. We've had reggaeton, mambo, son jarocho meets the Middle East. It doesn't matter, because to me, our people are that big, and we're here to answer that call. The Soraya was a platform in which we could demonstrate that the orchestra is ready to perform music from Peru, music from Mexico, music from all over the world. And we always try to show that we are world-class artists at the highest level of jazz performance, but nestled, rooted in the pueblo, in the people, because we don't make that distinction. We don't make a distinction between high art and the pueblo, the people. We believe they're even equal, and that music we play is the greatest music that we can, but rooted in our souls and in our communities. There aren't words with which to describe the power of music to transcend hatred, to transcend geopolitical borders, even to transcend physical matter. And so Jorge Francisco Castillo is a gentleman I met through a New York Times article, and he's been doing this incredible thing called the Fandango at the Fronterizo, I think now for 13 years. And I just joined up with him. I met up with him in Veracruz, in Jalapa, and we spent time together just deciding that we were gonna do this project, this film, this record, these concerts, a book. And thank goodness for my friend and mentor, Kabir Segal, who believed in the project from the start. And he's been able to help us really, really put this thing on the ground. And so Fandango at the Wall is more than a recording. It's more than a concert. It's more than a film. It is a way of life. Our hope is that they will see a country that is not Mexico or the United States, but a country that is both. are hoping that they will see that we are such an integral part of one another's lives, such an integral part of one another's economies, such an integral part of one another's culture, that we're inseparable. And we hope that the Fandango concert will show people how much a part of each other we truly, truly, truly are.
Bueno, este teatro precioso de Soraya es un teatro de tradición, es un teatro muy cálido. Creo que fue un concierto que me dejó muy contenta porque tanto el mariachi como el público, la respuesta del público, nos da lo mejor que se le puede dar a un artista: el aplauso, la aceptación, la simpatía. Y yo llegué con la misma disposición para dar lo mejor de mí y me llevé a mi casa lo mejor que este público hermoso y el mariachi me dieron, que fue su aplauso, que fue su aceptación. Bueno, pues nuestro repertorio mexicano es muy amplio, pero nos situamos específicamente en lo que es la música del centro de la República Mexicana. Esa música que se ha hecho famosa internacionalmente, que es la música de mariachi, con las grandes figuras de esta música, las más representativas, como lo son José Alfredo Jiménez, Tomás Méndez, Hugo Sánchez, Manuel Esperón, Chucho Monje, tantos otros, que realmente íbamos, como se dice popularmente, en caballo de hacienda. Tenemos un árbol cultural y artístico musical tan potente que en cualquier parte del mundo esa música, al cantarla, alegra los corazones y hace que la gente grita, y hace que la gente grite: ¡Viva México, señoras y señores! Yo les saludo a la comunidad mexicana y latina en Los Ángeles con todo amor y decirles que muy pronto, algún día, más pronto que tarde, nos volveremos a ver en persona para seguirles cantando lo que les gusta, seguir sintiendo su abrazo y decirles que desde aquí, de esta Ciudad de México, está una amiga, está una hermana. Les mando muchos besos.